What's up guys, welcome to another video for the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. My name's Pete and today we're going to be talking about how you can add stream labels into your OBS Studio stream. So stream labels are text files which basically allow you to display things like your top donator of the day or the week or even of all time, or things like sub trains or follower trains, any of those kind of elements that you want to include into your stream. That's what we're going to be covering today. Now, if anybody's been following the Gaming Careers channel for a little while, you might think this sounds quite similar to the last video that we did, which was on alerts. But the difference between alerts and labels are alerts are real-time events that sort of flash up on your stream and disappear within, you know, 10 seconds or something, so getting a new subscriber or a donation. Whereas labels, these are more long-term events, something that might appear on your stream consistently, like your most recent follower, and it'll always show your most recent follower until somebody new follows, and the most recent follower will then update, or your top donator of the day, week, or month, like I said earlier. Now, the Stream Labels application is actually a program that you download to your computer, unlike the alerts that we used last week. But similarly, it is also made by the people over at Streamlabs, previously known as Twitch Alerts, but they've obviously rebranded to Streamlabs now. So what we're going to be covering in this video is where to get the application from, how to download and install it, then how to customize the actual messages that get printed to the text files, and then we're going to be covering how you add that into OBS Studio, and then you can customize the look and feel of the text so it looks great on your stream. So let's jump in. So the first thing we need to do is to head over to the Streamlabs website, which is where we're going to be downloading the software from. So that's streamlabs.com, and you'll need to log in with your Twitch or your YouTube account. And if this is the first time that you've used Streamlabs, you'll have to authenticate the account with Twitch, but that's pretty simple to do. So once we're at the dashboard, we want to be scrolling down the left-hand side looking for the Stream Labels tab. And click that, and then we've got the options to download for Windows or for Mac OS X, and there is a Linux version in the works, so hopefully that will be out soon as well. Click to download for the correct operating system and save the file wherever you'd like. It's worth mentioning here that Stream Labels used to be a Chrome Web Store app, but since Google Chrome are going to be removing all of the apps in 2017, I guess because the platform didn't really take off like they wanted it to, Streamlabs have decided to make their Stream Label software downloadable instead. Once the file's finished downloading, you can open it up and it should just take a couple of seconds and a couple of clicks to install, and then you'll be met with a new Stream Labels window where you can again log in with Twitch or YouTube. So select the option that you wish to and log into the software. Once you've logged in, you'll be greeted with a message welcoming you to the platform and also the option to choose an output directory. Now this is going to be the directory where all of the text files are going to be saved to. So it's worth creating a new folder, maybe on your desktop or if you have a separate part of your computer where you keep all of your streaming stuff, whack it in there, create a new folder, and all of the text files will be auto-generated. Next you'll see the Stream Labels dashboard, which is basically just a long list of all the events that have happened to people on your stream, so followers or subscribers, donations. This is very similar to what you see on the Streamlabs website, and it's a useful window to have open if you have a second monitor whilst you're streaming, because you're going to be able to see all the events related to your stream so you can welcome new followers or thank new donators. The next thing we're going to want to do is click up on the File Settings button, and this is going to open up a window showing all the different text files that you can generate using the Stream Label software. So you've got things all about top donators or top donators of the month, as you can see, subscriber things, follower things, loads and loads of different information that you can show using OBS Studio. We're just going to select one at random here. Let's take most recent follower, and you'll see that we're presented with a new window where we can customize exactly how that looks in the text file. So we can change the text, and we get to use this name token, which is going to be the name of the person that has recently followed you. Let's say you wanted to have some different text rather than recent follower. Let's say, welcome to the family, and then their name. You just change the text here, and you can see at the preview at the bottom exactly what that will look like. Once you're happy, you can click Save Settings, and then you can go around and play with all the different types of notifications that you can get and change the text so it appears exactly as you want it to on your stream for your viewers. Now that we've got Stream Labels set up and it's also generating these text files, we need to now add those text files into OBS Studio so that they appear on your stream. So let's open up OBS Studio. Now in OBS, we want to select the scene that we want these sources to appear in. So select it on the left-hand side and then go across to the sources box, click the plus button, and then click text GDI. Name it something easy to remember, because if you're going to be adding a few of these different labels, you don't want to be getting mixed up as to which one is which. So let's do the recent follower, and we're just going to name it recent follower. Now we can play around with the font and color and size in just a second, but first things first, let's get OBS actually reading the file. So if you select the checkbox next to read from file and then click browse and navigate to the folder that you set up earlier, then you'll want to find the text file that corresponds to the thing that you're wanting to add in. So for us, that was recent follower. We find it here, select it, and press open. Now that we can see it's reading the file correctly, let's press select font to customize the font that we're using and also to change the size. Now, like I've said in a number of different videos on OBS, you want to be changing the font size here rather than later on when you get the red box around your text and dragging it, because that will create jagged edges. It doesn't scale the text properly if you drag the corners. So you want to always be coming back into the font properties and adjusting the font size here if you need it larger or smaller. Next, we can change things like the font color or gradient if you want more than one color, as well as the background color and the opacity of both the text and the background. Finally, we can change the alignment if you want to, but for me, I'm just going to leave these options as they are and press OK. Now, if we look at the top left of our OBS preview window, we can see the red box, maybe with some text in the middle if we've already got a recent follower, and we can now drag that around to wherever we want to position it within our stream. As always, make sure that you're looking down at the sources window and making sure that this text is above any gameplay or webcams or overlays that you want the text to appear above. Now all we need to do is repeat that same process for any other labels that we want to add to our stream. And one thing that's really worth mentioning is that you need to have stream labels open and running whenever you're streaming and you want these labels to appear, because the software actually needs to be running to generate the updates to these text files. So if you don't have it running, it's not going to update the text files, and therefore they're just going to have the most recent follower from when you last had the program running. Another quick tip is in the stream labels software, you can see you have this restart session button at the top. A lot of the text files that you can generate are based around streaming sessions. So if you want to see the top donator of the day or of the streaming session, then you can actually click here to restart the session, let's say if you're streaming multiple times in a day. So if you want the biggest donator of this stream, you might need to restart the session if you haven't restarted the software. The stream label software also allows you to repeat any alerts that didn't show properly on your stream for whatever reason, as well as skip certain alerts. Let's say you notice that somebody's abusing the text-to-speech bot or something like that. You can then use this software to skip the alerts. So if you haven't yet checked out my other video that I previously did on how to add alerts, like follower alerts, donation alerts, subscriber alerts, then this software also helps manage that kind of stuff whilst you are streaming. Hopefully you found this video helpful and you have a great looking stream now with some labels included. Let me know down in the comments below which label you guys are using the most often. So there's a huge list of the different types of text files you can generate. I'd be really interested to know which ones you guys are using for your streams. As always, if you've enjoyed the video, please do give it a thumbs up. And subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.